Sacha y
est.
Quel ouvert? Ah, on n'a pas de mal à ce que tu veux pour YouTube. Bearings are used to reduce the friction. Bearings are used to reduce the friction. That is the main purpose of the bearing, to reduce the friction. So if this one is a shaft, you can put the bearing there and the bearing there, then the shaft rotate onto or inside the bearing. So here we are having a bearing. We are also having a gear. This is a gear connected in series with a bearing or in one shaft. From there, we are having another bearing. From there, you also have this one. It's a pulley. So this one's a bearing. We also have a bearing here. Bearings, they reduce friction. As they reduce friction, means that the one which will be the shaft. So on the bearing, there will be a force. The weight of this, the weight of that, the weight of the shaft itself, they are all exerted on the bearing. Meaning you end up having a radial load on the bearing. You end up having a radial load on the bearing, which this one, it will be your action. So this one's a gear. You have a pinion and a gear. Gear connected on the shaft. The pinion driving the gear. This one is a pulley. Remember, a pulley, it has belt connected to another pulley. This side is T1, this side is T2. So on this one, when you are told to calculate the radial load on the bearing, meaning you're supposed to calculate reactions on the bearing. Therefore, you should know how long from there to there, also how long from there to there, also how long from there to there, in order for you to calculate those reactions. So we can put it in this manner. There's a reaction at the bearing. This one, there's a force on the gear. Here, there's another reaction on the bearing. There's also force on the pulley. So, there can be also another force in the center. The force in the center, if ever you're given the weight of the shaft, it means your shaft becomes a UTM if you are given the weight of the shaft. Do you understand that part, man? Okay. So now, let us start. This one I did not indicate direction. Even this one I did not indicate the direction. Let us look on the direction of this one. Let's take this pulley. It has a weight of tell you to. In which direction does a wave go? It means the wave will go downwards, right? Yes, the wave is gonna go down. But you also need T1 and T2. Remember when this belt, they are pulling this pull upwards. Now we are not checking on the rotation. The belt is, let's say the belt now is stationary, meaning this belt is tight. If you can come and hold here, try to put it together. This shaft when it goes up, right? Meaning T1 and T2, they are pulling this one upwards. They are pulling the pulley upwards. Meaning we have the installation tension, which is T1 plus T2, which is going up. Meaning if on the same position, we have the weight, which is pulling it down, we also have the installation tension pulling it up. Do you understand that one? So meaning you can take, for you to left with one force, you can take this one and subtract there, or take this one and subtract there. If the belt was going down, the weight is going down, and the T1, T2, they are also going down. Meaning here, this one, it will be also going down, right? T installation tension is also going down. Therefore, the total force here, it will be a weight plus installation tension. Do you get that part? Yes. But if it goes to the opposite, it means you must take the greater subtract the law. Do you understand that one? Eh? Yes. So let us check the gear. In which direction does it go? The force on the gear. For me to explain the force on the gear, I will have to take this out. We will come back for it. We're having a pinion and a gear. We will use a pinion as our driver. The pinion is a driver. We'll use it as a driver. The gear is a driver. The gear, it will be the one which is connected to the shaft. The shaft which is connected to the other, to the bearings. Do you get that part, right? So, okay. Let us take this, that this is busy rotating to this other side. When is busy rotating on this other side? You are going to have a radial force acting on the two bearings. Radial force acting on the two bearings. As the two gears rotate, like this one, they rotate in mesh. The radial force tend to pull those gears away from each other. I'm not sure if you have ever witnessed that one. When the gears are rotating, you see as if the gears are moving away from each other. That one's a radial force. Meaning the radial force is pulling it away. Meaning the radial force for this one will pull it downwards. The radial force for this one will pull it upward. This is a radial force. Also, this is a radial force. This is a radial force. The Puma. But thinking we are going to kill him if he did. Do you understand the radial force? Eh? Do you guys understand the radial force? The radial force is pulling these two gears away from each other. Meaning the radial force for this one is pulling down. The radial force for this one is pulling up. Do you understand that part? Ne? Yes. So meaning, if now you are having this one, this is the shaft. This is the shaft. If your shaft, here you are having a gear and a pinion, what will be the direction of your radial force here? It means you use the downwards, right? So if your this is your shaft, this is your gear, this is your pinion, which direction will be your radial force? You will use the upwards, right? Because agree you are using this gear which is connected to the shaft. This one is going down, but you won't use this gear because this gear is not the one which is connected to the shaft. If you were to use a radial force. You understand that one? Yes. So there's also a tangential force and a normal force. So this is a driver. When you see, even if they did not tell you, once you see one arrow there, here without an arrow, it means this becomes a driver. So the tangential force. Tangential force is acting here and the normal force there. So tangential force, it must be perpendicular to the radius, right? So the tangential force perpendicular to the radius is either goes that direction or goes to this direction. For a driver, a tangential force will oppose the direction of the driver. So meaning the tangential force, it goes in that direction for the driver. For a driven, it means it opposes that one. Do you understand that one? Eh? For a driver, it opposes the direction. For a driven, it opposes this one. Otherwise, it's the same force. The tangential force here is the same as this tangential force. Radial force, this one is the same as this radial force. Opposite direction, but equal. So, normal force, it will be in between the two. It means normal force for this one, it will go to this direction. At an angle of 20, involute angle, or pressure angle, 20. Metric size, that is 20, that is standard. So meaning for this one, in between this one, it will come this side. There's 20. So we can take this one, we close it there. We take this one, we close it there. Can you see? This one becomes resultant. So in a simpler terms, when I'm having these two gears, I'm having a pinion. I'm having a pinion and a gear. This is the gear, this is the pinion. If this goes to this direction, tangential force will go to this direction. Normal force at 20 degrees above. Then a radial force is up. This is a radial force. This one is a tangential force. This one is a normal force. So you can take this one, you can take this one, you move it here. Your normal force. Can you see that one? For this one, it's the same thing here, just that I'm separating it from here so that you do not get confused. This one, as tangential force goes this side for this one, it means tangential force for this one will go to this direction. Radial force, remember, I said always it opposes that one. Normal force is 20 degrees from tangential. Meaning here is 20. We can take this force and we place it here. This one is a normal force. Yeah, quiet down. It means you understand. Radial force. This one is a tangential force. This one is a normal force. And if you check here, this is a triangle, that's a triangle. This tangential force is, the, is equal to this tangential force. This radial force is the same as this one. Normal force this side is the same as that one. The only thing you need to understand is the direction. But for your syllabus, what I have seen there, they will tell you in which direction. It's either they will tell you that is going up or down. What I have seen there. So okay, in this case, meaning we can interpret this one in terms of normal force. Or in terms of the two. Why here am I having two normal force? This is radial, right? Yes. Meaning if I want to find, if I'm having tangential force, I want to find normal, which trigonometric ratio do I use? Sorry? I use sine. If I want, I have tangential, I need to find radial, which one do I use? Sorry? I have tangential, this is tangential. Then I need to find radial. I use tan, yes, from this diagram. So, how do I find tangential? How do I find tangential force? Power is equal to 2 pi n t over 60. This is the power transmitted. This is the power transmitted. If ever the speed of this one, is it the same as this one? It's not the same, eh? Meaning you should find the torque here, you must also find the torque there. So meaning torque is equal to F tangential times radius. And this force times radius. In this case, our radius is PCD over 2. And that's a radius. Yes. So this is how you will calculate your tangential force from the top. Meaning, if this power, you are given this power for this pool. No, you are given this power, you are given power for this gear or for this pinion. You will calculate the top using the speed there. Using the same speed of this one. And then you will get the tangential force for this one. You understand that one? Eh? Having the tangential force for this one. Don't you have the tangential force for this one? You do, right? Yes, once you have the tangential force for this one, you have the tangential force for this one. The other part. Yes, equal but in the opposite direction. Do you understand that part? Right? So we are saying tangential force for a pinion is the same as tangential force for what? For the gear. Let us write that one. Tangential force for the pinion is equal to tangential force for the gear. This is tangential force, right? So when I substitute here, tangential force for the gear, no, for the pinion, it will be 2 torque pinion times, not times, divided by PCD for pinion. I just make this subject of the same way. I read that the same. It's equal to this side. 2 P of the gear divided by PCD for the gear. So from there, 2 and 2 cancel. After 2 and 2 have canceled, You can even say T for the gear divided by T for the pinion is equals to PCD for the gear over PCD for the pinion. Can you see that one? From the previous chapter, is this not a gear ratio? That's a gear ratio. So meaning that gear ratio, we can also use it with what? With torque. Meaning once you have a gear ratio, you can use it with torque. Torque gear, PCD gear, torque pinion, PCD pinion. So, before we go back to that structure, let me see if I'm not omitting something. Okay, it seems as I'm not omitting anything. So we are having a bearing and after that we have the gear. From there, we have another bearing. This bearing can you can put it anywhere, even after the pulley. Then we have the pulley. This T1, this T2. So, the pulley, it has a weight of 50 Newton. The gear, it has the weight of 25 Newton. So, from there to there is 25. Millimeters, from there to there is 60 millimeters, from there to the center of this one it's 45 millimeters, for example. So this is the gear, it has that weight. This is the pulley, it has this weight. Then they said the maximum stress of the belt is equal to 50 Newton per centimeter square. The area of the belt, I think this one is the previous chapter. Maximum stress on the belt, Newton centimeter, whereas the 10 centimeter square, then T1 over T2 is equals to 4. From there, the pinion drives the power on the pinion, or the power transmitted is equal to 25 kilowatts at a speed of 240 rev per minute. Then the direction of the is this one. In this case, I just want to see if you will able to, but you, for your standard or for your syllabus, they will tell you which force you're supposed to use here, right? They will also tell you in which direction, is it up or down? They will tell you if you're supposed to use a normal force. Meaning they will tell you that the normal force here is horizontal, or the radial force is horizontal down, or vertical up, or they give it as an arrow, you will see from the arrow. So I'm just giving this question to see your understanding. So okay, let us draw this one in terms of a beam. In terms of a beam, remember the main aim here, we should calculate the reaction at the two bearings. This is the left bearing, this is the right bearing. The aim here is to calculate the reactions there, which is the radial force on the bearing. So what do we do? This one, it will be radial force on the bearing, left bearing. And this one, it will be radial force on the right bearing. So here, I'm also having a force here. In which direction does this force go? Downwards, right? Which force is that one? Sorry? Radial force. Radial force is going down. It's only radial force. Sorry? Plus a weight, right? Yes, plus a weight. A weight of the key. Are you given the weight of the key? Yes. So what about here? Which direction does the force go? Down. Mm-hmm. Sorry? Sorry? Radial force here. It's a weight. Which T? Installation torque, installation tension, not torque. Installation tension is T1 plus T2. Not effective tension. Installation tension is T1 plus T2. So if this value was going up, it means we're going to subtract, right? Because they're going to the different direction. So from here to here is 25. From there to there is 60. From here to here is 45 millimeters. So we managed to draw our beam whereby we can calculate the reaction. So now we cannot able to calculate with a lot of unknowns. We only need two unknowns for us to start calculating. So here we do have the weight, right? Given. Do we have a radial load? We don't have a radial load, right? So maybe here I must also include PCD as 80 millimeters. So how to calculate radial force? Sorry? How to calculate that torque is equal to? Sorry? Power. power is equals to 2 pi n t over 16. Eh? So t is equals to, it will be 30 p over pi n. Is it correct? You are still processing. Either it's cross multiple, you take this one, you multiply there, you take 2, we divide, we have 30. We divide also by this 2, you left with t. So that formula appears to be correct. Okay, I'll be using this smaller space. This one I'll write it here, t max is equals to 50 newton per centimeter square. A is equals to 10 centimeter cube. Then t1 over t2 is equals to 4. So okay, when you calculate top, it will be 30 times 25 exponent 3 all over pi times 240. What you get is your power. What is your power? Unze manu calculate. This is the same as times 10 over 3. Agree, here is Q. Yes, this one is times 10 to the power 3, this one. It's just my shortcut. Sorry? 9? 72, eh? Newton meter. Now we have a top. So having the top, for the fact that we have used the speed here, it means this top is for this one. My information is crack. Oh, it's okay. I have all information I need, eh? So what do I do now? I do what? I calculate FT. Eh? This FT is for which gear? For the pinion, right? And the tangential force here, what's the relationship with the tangential force here? They're equal. Eh? Meaning calculating for this one is the same as calculating for this one. Okay, then. Sorry? How do I calculate? Top over PCD. Do you understand the formula? Or I must start by saying T is equals to 4, T is equals to force times radius. Must I start like that? So, okay. And then when we substitute is 994.72 times this 2 all over PCD is 0.03. And what we get is our force. Put it in kilonewton. Kilonewton. So now we are having tangential force. And yet we need transition force. What was the reason for us to calculate transition force? So that we can calculate radial force, right? And from the triangle, the one which we have drawn earlier, we had something like this. This one, it was tangential force. This one, it was radial force. This one, it was normal force. We are not interested for normal force because here we're going to use radial, not normal, right? Yes, but if the question said we're supposed to use radial, we're going to use calculate radial. So now we are calculating. If the question said we need to use normal, we're going to calculate normal. So now we're calculating radial because of this. Yes. So what is the involute angle here? It's 20 degrees. So how to calculate the radial force? Sorry? Tan 20 FR over FT. So meaning FR is equals to 66.314 exponent 3 tan 20. And what do you get? That is 10 to the power 3, that exponent. Sorry? 24.14 kilo Newton. Okay, now we do have FR and we do have W. Meaning we will add the two to get the force here. Here we have the weight. Do you have installation tension? Hit the wall. You know, it's just that I wrote add X, I was supposed to write weight. Weight is supposed to 25. But if they say ignore weight, it means you will only take FR. If yet you also don't have weight, you will also take FR. Yes, installation tension. For us to calculate installation tension, what do we need? T1 and T2, ne? Yes. Can we be able to calculate T1 and T2? How do you calculate T1 and T2? Sorry? T1 is equal to? Sorry? Times? Times 10. This one they said per centimeter squared. And this one is given in centimeter. So to remove that centimeter, we multiply with centimeter squared. So it's 50 times 10, which will give us 500 Newton. So how to get T2? T1 over T2 is equals to 4, meaning it's 500 over 4 is equals to T2. And what would be the magnitude of T2? Yeah? 125 Newton. So what would be the, how to calculate the installation tension? T1 plus T2, which would be 500 plus 125, it gives us 625 Newton. So this is the force which you add there. After adding here, are you done with your calculations? You are not done, eh? You still need to take reactions. So now, I want us to calculate reactions. I can take off this one. You want to copy? Yeah, you can copy first. We're running out of time. The next key you're attending here. Sorry? Kuala. Yeah, so it means we'll get, when they arrive, they tell me. Yeah, let me quickly try to explain them. So what is the total force you got here? Sorry? 6-2 is a intuition as well. It was 25 plus?
24.4.
And what you get? I get 25, it was the weight. I think it's 29. No, not 29. Yeah, 49. 49.14. And this one here?
It was
50. Yeah, it was 50. Which is 6.75, okay? Yes. So, to calculate the reaction here, you have two unknowns. You must take bending moment, right? So, what's the element that when you take bending moment? You have two unknowns. You must eliminate one. If you take moment about this one, this point where you have first unknowns, either you take here or you take here. When you take bending moment about this one, it's like here you're putting a pin to make this a fulcrum, to make this line, to make this one a fulcrum of this line. A fulcrum is where it can able to swim. Eh? Just imagine as this one is just a bar which can able to swim. So this one is a force which is pushing up. This one is pushing down. So when you take moment here, you check which forces they will push the beam clockwise when you take this as your fulcrum, or when you take moment here. You multiply with the distance. You equate with the one off and clockwise. For instance, when you are here, in which direction does this push? And clockwise, then. So this one? Clockwise. Meaning when we take this one as our bending moment, this push anti-clockwise, these are the anti-clockwise one, which means it's 49.414. Multiplied by how long from there, where we're taking moment up until there? 25 millimeters. Do I have any other force? Yes, even this one, you can push clockwise, meaning you will add 6.75 multiply by how long from where we're taking moment up until to that force? Sorry? 30. 180. Do we have any other force? No. This one is pushing upwards. Then it's squashed to. When it pushes upwards, it means this thing it will start swinging and clockwise about this point, which it will be R multiplied by, I think the first place is R. How long from there to there? Sorry? 85. If you check, only R is unknown. From there you can solve R. Same applies. You make this your fulcrum or you take moment about this one. You check anti-clockwise and clockwise. Therefore, you get the reaction here. Avoid using upwards as opposed to downwards after you have calculated this one. Because if you use that one, if this is wrong, automatically this one it will be wrong. But if you take reaction, if this one is wrong, the chances that you get this correct in the high. You can just confirm if up is close to down.